Welcome back to my channel. My name is Emily Fink and I am an opera singer and also a connoisseur of anything vintage and old-fashioned from about the 1920s to the 1960s, including music, movies, fashion, and more. So thank you for joining me for another video. Today, as you can see, it is Christmas time by the tree in the background. So I thought it would be fun to talk about some of my favorite classic Christmas songs. I don't know if that's even the best word, old-fashioned, whatever you want to call it, but they're Christmas songs that were recorded somewhere between like the 1940s and the 1960s. There might be a couple from the 1930s, I haven't really looked at dates on them, but they are definitely before the 1960s, most of them probably more from the 40s and 50s. So I'm gonna give you my top 15 Christmas songs, and these are just songs that to me are songs that I could listen to on repeat during the Christmas season that really make me feel like it's Christmas time and I don't ever get tired of hearing. So they're my favorites in that sense. I also have a couple more categories. I have my top 15 and then I have some other ones that we're gonna talk about. We're actually gonna start with one of those categories first. So we're gonna start with new discoveries. And we are going to start with Jingling Jingling by the Andrews Sisters.
Jing, jingling, 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 what fun to hear the sleigh bells jingle. Jing, jingling, 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 they set your heart a-tingle.
It was funny, I was listening to this song and while we were decorating and my sister came in from the garage in the middle of the song. She says, "What are you listening to?" And I said, "It's the Andrews Sisters." And she goes, "It sounds like a circus song." Since if you just like pick up in the middle of the song, there's an instrumental in there, and it does kind of sound like circus music or something like that. It's a really fun song though. So we're going to move on to Brazilian Sleigh Bells by Harry James. This isn't one that I discovered this year. I actually discovered it last year, but it's one that I kind of forgotten about. So it's like rediscovering it all over again. Harry James just was a smooth trumpet player and it was gorgeous. And Brazilian Sleigh Bells is such a cool song. Definitely well worth a listen. And you'll be having it in your head. You'll have the song in your head all the time after you listen to it. Next song is The Wonderful World of Christmas by Elvis.
The wonderful world of Christmas is a wonderful world.
When I was young, probably, I don't know, 6 or 7 or 8, my dad bought my sister and I each an Elvis CD. I had kind of gotten out of listening to Elvis for a few years, and I don't know, a couple years ago I got back into him. He was especially like his younger music. It wasn't until this year that I was like, well, he made like 3 Christmas albums. What are these songs on there? And this was one of them. It's a beautiful song. And just the sentiment behind all of his Christmas songs is really, really sweet. This is really nice. All right, so last of my new discoveries category is the song The Christmas Waltz by Mel Torme.
For you and for me, it's the time of year when the world falls in love.
I have heard Frank Sinatra sing this song as well, and he does an excellent job. The song itself is beautiful, and so, you know, many different singers can sing it and you'll still like it. Some songs only lend themselves to certain voice types and whatever, so the song itself is just such a good song that different singers can sing it. But Mel Torme's version of it is different than Frank Sinatra's. And not that Frank Sinatra's is bad, it's good for the time that it was done and for, like, it's Frank Sinatra's style, Mel Torme's is Mel Torme's style. I just prefer Mel Torme's style because it's a little bit more theatrical, I guess would be the best word to describe that. It reminds me almost of like something by Lerner and Lowe, like from My Fair Lady or something like that. It's absolutely gorgeous. every time it comes on, I just like have to stop whatever I'm doing and just sit there and listen to it in silence, because it is breathtakingly beautiful. All right, so we are going to start in on my top 15 list. Number 15, A Marshmallow World by Dean Martin.
It's a marshmallow world in the winter, when the snow comes to cover the ground.
This is such a really cute song. It really like glorifies the whole thing about snow. I don't know why, if it's just like the time of year that we happen to be around snow, it's always more like ice and or slush, you know, or mud. It's not the glorious white pillows of snow or the marshmallow world that Dean Martin makes it out to be, but it's really fun to listen to. All right, number 14 is If Every Day Was Like Christmas by Elvis.
Fills the air. Oh, why can't every day be like Christmas?
This just goes right along with what I was saying about Elvis's songs, his Christmas songs, and the meaning behind them, and kind of the whole, like, the theme around most of his Christmas songs was kind of the same. And this one, I think, exemplifies that the best. It's such a beautiful song.
Well, this would be
number 13, Deck the Hall, which, let me just point out real quick, is that is the name of the song, Deck the Hall. I thought it was always plural, and I thought the title was plural, but Wayne Newton has it as Deck the Hall. Also one that I just discovered this year, however, I included it on this list because the minute I heard it, it became my favorite version of this song ever. What Wayne Newton does to this song is so cool. It sounds completely different than any other version I've ever heard, but in the best way. Number 12 is We Wish You the Merriest by Frank Sinatra featuring Bing Crosby and Fred Waring.
The merriest, the merriest, the merriest, yes, the merriest. We wish you the merriest, the merriest, the merriest you'll cheer.
When I first listened to this song a couple years ago, and it was just so fun. They just had so much fun in the recording studio, and you can hear it on their recordings.
May your tree be filled with happiness.
All right, number 11 is March of the Toys from Babes in Toyland. And keeping with, there's so many orchestras or symphonies that have recorded this over the years, but sticking with theme, I'm including it by Tommy Dorsey's orchestra. Instrumentals on here, and March of the Toys from Babes in Toyland is one of them. This song is just so cute. It's a really Christmassy song in a very different kind of way. Number 10 is Santa Claus Came in the Spring by the Benny Goodman Orchestra.
Santa Claus came in the spring. Santa Claus came when the skies were blue. I heard his sleigh.
Not positive if this is a Christmas song or not, but I include it on my Christmas playlist. Like I was saying earlier, I think most of the songs are from like the 1940s and after, but this one was in the 30s. Obviously it was by the Benny Goodman Orchestra, so it was gonna be earlier. It's kind of hard to describe why I like this song so much. I love the sound and the the lyrics are cute and whatever, but it's more of the music itself that kind of intrigues me, and it's just very like stylistically sounds like the 30s.
Every day because
Number 9, Christmas Is a Comin' by Bing Crosby.
When I'm feeling blue and when I'm feeling low, then I start to think.
You didn't think I wasn't in include any Bing Crosby on here, did you? The only reason that I haven't mentioned him so far is because pretty much the rest of this list is Bing Crosby. It's one of those just like kind of traditional songs that you can find in a Christmas songbook or something, but it's just a really cute song, and it gets you in the Christmas mood, and I don't get tired of listening to it.
Take time to fret, and the more you give at Christmas.
Number 8 is In the Christmas Mood by Glenn Miller Orchestra. I thought it was hilarious when I found this song a couple years ago, because I love the Glenn Miller Orchestra. He is my favorite big band orchestra. And one of the most famous songs by the Glenn Miller Orchestra is In the Mood. And so this song is called In the Christmas Mood, which is also the sound of both of their, they came out with two Christmas albums, and the first one is In the Christmas Mood Volume 1, and the other one is In the Christmas Mood Volume 2. When you listen to the song, you can actually hear some of the like famous sections from In the Mood incorporated into the song. A lot of times, what I've also found really cool is those things that you hear them do in their own songs when they do covers, or in this instance, like Christmas songs, they kind of mesh the two together, and so that it's just completely stylistically submerged in their own style, and it's still that Christmas song, but it's so identifiable as that artist. As a song as well, it's just really cool, and it actually has lyrics to it, as opposed to how In the Mood does not have lyrics. I enjoy that part of it, and it sounds very Christmassy, but then to just hear like these little parts that are so iconic of the Glenn Miller Orchestra is just really fun. Number 7 is Go Tell It on the Mountain by Jim Nabors.
Go tell it on the mountain, over the hills and everywhere.
Most people don't know that Jim Nabors could sing. He was actually very operatic in the way that he sang. He is a baritone, and he just had a gorgeous voice. He's actually my favorite singer to listen to sing The Impossible Dream from Man of La Mancha, which I highly recommend anybody listening to. If you want to know a good version to listen to, find the version on YouTube of when he sang The Impossible Dream on the show Gomer Pyle USMC. Find the clip of that because it's the best ever. But anyways, his version of Go Tell It on the Mountain, though, is quite a charm. Just a really fun version of it, but also kind of shows off the lower side of his voice.
They saw the star.
Number 6, We Need a Little Christmas by Johnny Mathis.
Call out the holly, put up the tree before my spirit falls again.
We Need a Little Christmas is from the movie Mame, which I believe was also a show. I'm not an expert on the show at all, so I don't know if it was a show before the movie or after the movie or what. I do know that Lucille Ball was in the movie, that's why I know that. But Johnny Mathis sings We Need a Little Christmas. I don't know if he was the original singer in the movie or not. But he's the one that is most popular for the recording. I love this song. It's so fun and just like so Christmassy to me. And this is definitely one song though that when I talk about listening to a song on repeat, not getting tired of it, is it. Alright, we have made it to number 5. And number 5 is Melakaliki Maka by Bing Crosby and the Andrews Sisters.
Melakalikimaka is a thing to say on a bright.
I don't know how you could not know this song, because even to this day it is still played on the radios, and if you even don't know necessarily the song, when I just played it, I'm sure you recognized it, even if you didn't know the title or who sang it or whatever. But it's just so traditional and such a classic. It's so nostalgic. There's only a few songs that I will actively go and like choose to listen to that song. Normally I just like shuffle my playlist or whatever, These songs are definitely ones that I would choose to listen to or I stop to listen to, but these top five are definitely songs that I will just, oh, let's go play that song. Let's go play that song again. That we send to you from the land. Number four, Joy to the World by Nat King Cole. I know.
Joy to the world, the Lord is come, let earth receive.
I know I don't have, like, a ton of traditional Christmas songs on here, Christmas carols, have you, and these singers all did record lots of Christmas carols, but most of them were just pretty standard for the, you know, for being the carol, they're singing the carol. And they're not necessarily ones that I would go and choose to listen to again, just because, like I said, there's so many singers that sing them, so you hear them all the time already. So that's kind of my little explanation for that. Don't get me wrong, I adore those Christmas carols. They are, I mean, we couldn't have Christmas without those carols, in my opinion, because they are classics. They are so representative of this season and what the season is all about. And if I were to tell you what my favorite Christmas song is, I would probably choose from one of those. But like I said, for the sake of this video, I've kind of tried to keep it to ones that I would actively go and let's go listen to it. You know what I mean? All that being said, Nat King Cole's version of Joy to the World is by far my favorite. The arrangement of it with background voices is such a beautiful arrangement. Number three, we're to the top three, is Christmas Journey by Wayne Newton.
There's a magic in the air, snow is falling everywhere.
I first heard this song on an episode of Bonanza. Wayne Newton was in two episodes of Bonanza, maybe three. I think it was only two though. But he sings this song on Bonanza, and when my sister and I both heard the song, we were like, I gotta go find that song, gotta go find that song. And we ended up did. He recorded it for his Christmas album, and it's just such a beautiful song. Oh my gosh. I don't even know how I'm gonna be saying the same thing. I shouldn't even need to explain the other songs. Just take that portion and paste it onto all of the other two songs that I'm gonna talk about, because I just like, they're the top songs on my list because I just love them so much. It's not like all the other songs I talked about, like it was, oh, you know, this is a really cool feature of it, or this is a really cool feature, or they do this. But with these top songs on my list, they just give you, and this is what music should do, I think. And that's one of the wonderful things about music. And that's why music is so essential to so many people during holidays, and especially during the Christmas season. There is so much that revolves around the music, because it brings back memories, it gives you emotions, and it just makes the season so much more. And that's what these songs do for me, and it just becomes hard to explain why you love the songs, because it's such a personal emotion and a personal feeling that you get when you listen to it. And all I can do is tell you that I love these songs. My number two is White Christmas by Bing Crosby. I think this has to be one of the most beautiful Christmas songs ever written. I mean, it was and is still the most popular Christmas song. It was number one. It is still Bing Crosby's number one most sold and listened to song ever. And it might even be the most sold and listened to song of all time, which is saying something. I've listened to so many different people sing this song, and oh sure, you could probably tell me people that have better voices than Bing, although, I mean, I would probably disagree with you because Bing Crosby is my favorite singer, but it doesn't change the fact of the feeling that you get when you listen to Bing Crosby sing it. And like I was just saying about that whole feeling that songs give you, that's kind of the whole point. Your day. Alright, before I get to number one, I do have a few honorable mentions, a few being five, because you know me.
a toddy that's good for everybody, that anyone can pour and be the host.
I really, really like this song. However, it makes me rather confused, and I cannot explain to you why, it just does. It makes me confused, but yet I still like the song. I like the song because I like the lyrics, and Bing Crosby singing it is beautiful. But there's something about the music that is very different. There's just something about that song that, I don't know if it's just not quite right. I cannot put my finger on it. I like the song, but it baffles me.
City sidewalks, busy sidewalks, dressed in holiday style.
I'll have a blue Christmas without you. It's the most wonderful time of the year, with the kids jingle belling and everyone telling you be of good cheer. It's the most wonderful time of the year.
And now we can get on to my number one, at least for this year. If this was last year, it probably would have been White Christmas, but this year, the song that I cannot get enough of and is number one on my top 15 list. Actually, it's been more like 24 songs, but who's counting? Is Christmas Is Here to Stay by Bing Crosby.
For people to say Christmas is on its way.
Whenever you hear the bells ringing in your ear, you know what's coming just around.
I don't know what it is about this song this year that has just like captured my attention so much. I keep playing it over and over, and I just love listening to this song. And I'm saying that like I don't understand why, and I mean I kind of don't understand why, because it's a little different than what I would have guessed would be the song that I would have on repeat so much this season. But it is. It's such a good song. I love it. So good. It's so good. You gotta go listen to it.
You kinda get a taste of what's in store.
Well, there are my favorite songs of this Christmas season. And let me know in the comments what your favorite Christmas songs that you're listening to are right now, what songs you cannot get enough of, and have you discovered any new songs recently? Maybe it's one on this list. If you do listen to any of these songs, which I will include a playlist for in the comments in the description box, listen to the songs, and if you've never heard of some of these, check them out. Let me know what you think of them, if you like them, and if one of them becomes a new discovery for you that you just can't get enough of either, please let me know. I would love to know what you guys are listening to and enjoying this Christmas season.
Joy and fun.